In this video, we will see how we can find a triple integration. Now understand, the limits of integral are not given. Okay. Instead of that, it is said that this integral is to be evaluated over a tetrahedron bounded by all these planes. Okay. So we have to find out these limits. Limits are not given. And once you find out the limits, using those limits, we have to solve the integral. Okay. So first step I'm going to do as usual is let the integral be equal to I. And now the task is to find the limits of integral. And I'll show you how we can do this. Okay. So before we get to that, there are a few points that I want to make very clear that you have to understand these basics. It really helps. Look, when we have two dimensions, say you have X. Okay. Let me draw it here. Say when you have X axis and Y axis. Do you know the equation of x-axis is y equal to 0? And the reason is that every point on x-axis will have y coordinate 0. Let's say this point. This point will be 1, 0. Second point will be 2, 0. Next point will be 3, 0. Observe that all the points have y coordinate 0. You see that? And that's why the equation of this line is y equal to 0. My point that I'm trying to make is, on x-axis, y is 0. And of course, on y-axis, x will be 0. On y-axis, x is 0. Okay. So you just have to remember this point. And now we will extend this same idea to three dimensions. So let us draw a 3D diagram. Okay. Where I've got three axes perpendicular to each other. Let me draw a nice diagram here. This is x-axis. This is y-axis. And this over here is z axis. Okay. Now, this is the xy plane. This plane here is the xy plane. Now, when I say xy plane, okay, it's a 2D plane, right? On xy plane, the z value cannot exist. The z has to be zero on this plane. And z value zero gives it, now this plane will have equation z equal to 0. So when I say z equal to 0, which is one of our plane, okay, this is nothing but xy plane. Z equal to 0 is xy plane. I hope you understood this point very well. That on xy plane, the value of z has to be 0. Okay. Okay. So this is, by the way, this plane is also called as a principal plane. Okay. And that is z equal to 0. I'm sure you can now guess that when I say y equal to 0, okay, y equal to 0 plane has to be zx plane. So let me draw that as well. Zx plane here, this will have, and let always write down the equations of what we're talking about. So the equation of this is going to be y equal to 0, and equation of this plane over here, the equation of this plane is going to be x equal to 0. Okay, so all the three green planes are basically called as principal planes. Okay, I hope you can imagine this is a 3D diagram here. So if we just like, you know, and it's very easy to draw a 3D diagram, and you should be able to draw these diagrams. It is very important for an engineer to know how to draw a 3D diagram. Just have to make sure that I'm not really doing a good job somehow, but then I hope you get my point. That to draw a 3D diagram, you basically have to ensure that all lines are parallel to either. Like this line is parallel to this line, and this line is parallel to this line, and this line is parallel to this line, and this line is, and then you will always get a good looking diagram, hopefully. Okay, so, well, so now I have got three planes. Like one plane is this z equal to 0. This plane over here is going to be x equals 0. And this plane over here is going to be y equals 0. I hope you get that. Okay. Once we do all of that, so we have figured out the first three planes. They are all basically principal planes. Now, the next what I want to do is I want to draw this plane. Let's talk about this plane here. Okay. Now, I'll show you how we can find out about this plane. That in this case, supposing if I put y and z values as 0, let's say y is 0 and z is also 0. Now, if that happens, you clearly see x value is 1. Okay. So when y and z is 0, x is 1. Okay. When x is 0 and z is 0, like what if this is 0 and this is also 0? So you'll get y equal to 1. Okay. And what if x and y both are 0? Say this is 0 and this is 0. That will definitely give me z equal to 1. Okay. So that gives me z equal to 1. Okay. So from the equation x plus y plus z equal to 1, I've got 3 points: 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, and 0, 0, 1. So let's just say that this cube is of size 1. So like from here to here, it is 1 unit. Okay. Now you tell me, what are the coordinates of this point? This point is on x-axis. The coordinates are going to be 1, 0, 0. And this is on y-axis. This will be 0, 1, 0. And this is on z-axis. This will be 0, 0, 1. So I found out all the coordinates. Now, once you find out these coordinates, okay, and these coordinates are of the plane x plus y plus z equal to 1. So let me draw the plane as well. Okay. So now this red colored plane is x plus y plus z. Now this line is on good. So let's fix that. This plane here is x plus y plus z. So the red plane over here is x plus y plus z equal to 1. That's the plane here. Fair enough. So, okay. So now that's this triangular plane. Okay. Don't think those lines are necessary, but still. So now, if you have to imagine this tetrahedron, it's a tetrahedron that is inside all the three planes. Okay. So if I have to draw like another diagram, it is like this shape. Okay? That's the triangular plane. And then this is one side and this is the other side. And that's like the tetrahedron. Okay. What we're talking about. Anyways, I think these shadings are absolutely not needed. And let's just clear this diagram a bit more. Even this is really unnecessary. Just like adding to the complexity. But I hope you get the whole point of this thing. That that's the red plane. Let's fix the red plane again. Okay. So now, next, what we want to do is we want to solve this question, and the integral is evaluated inside this tetrahedron. So when you have an integral that is evaluated inside this tetrahedron, now what we will do is here we will take one strip. Now the strip goes like this. Let's just say this lines. Okay. Just pay attention. And these two lines. Okay. And there is this vertical strip. Is that better? That's the strip. Okay. So now if you can see, I hope you understood that this is a vertical strip whose base is going to be on the z plane, and it is going to get chopped off by this red plane. Okay, so that's like a vertical, it's a solid strip. Okay, so if this is the strip, okay, can you just like see my video? It's like the vertical strip. Now understand, whenever we draw a strip, okay, the strip always can move parallel to itself. What do you mean by that? The strip can move anywhere inside that volume that is bounded by the tetrahedron, and it moves parallel to itself. So basically what I'm trying to tell you is that this vertical strip can be here as well. Okay, so this is the lower end, and this triangle is going to be its upper end. Or it can be here. It becomes very, very small then. Okay. The lower end is the is the z equal to zero plane, and upper end is a triangle. So basically what I want you to understand is this vertical strip going to move parallel to itself. Okay, it can go anywhere inside this tetrahedron, and no matter where it goes, its lower end will always be on z is equal to zero, and its upper end will always be on the red plane. Okay, now from that, okay, I can write down that the lower end of the z will always be on the z equal to zero plane. That's why I write z lower as zero, and z upper, the upper end of the strip, the z upper is going to be always on the this red plane. Okay, and the equation of the red plane is x plus y plus z is equal to 1. So I can write z is equal to 1 minus x minus y. 1 minus x minus y. So this is z, the upper limit, and this is z, the lower limit. Okay, so, well, out of this integral, there is dx, dy, and dz, and we at least got the limits of z. So now just see how I solve this question. First of all, let I is equal to integration x and y we don't know, but limits of z we know for sure. So it's going to be z is equal to 0, the lower limit, that is z equal to 0, and the upper limit is going to be 1 minus x minus y. Basically I got upper limit of is from the strip, and the strip, the upper end of the strip is always resting on this red triangular plane, right? So that's going to be my upper limit. All right, fair enough. So z upper is going to be 1 minus x minus y, and then this is x plus y plus z dz, and dx dy will simply solve later. So this is how we got it, and we all know, right, that we always solve the inner integral first. So we will first solve the integration with respect to z. Okay, so this part we will solve first. Okay, let's do this. So I'll get I, integral x and y, we'll keep it for later. And when we are integrating with respect to z, now in this case here, we are integrating with respect to z. So we are only dealing with dz right now. So the variable is z, and x, y are constants. So we treat x and y as a constant while we are integrating with respect to z. So let's do that. So this x plus y is going to be a whole thing as a constant. So that will remain as it is. Okay, so this is x plus y as it is. And then one, the integration of one is going to be z. And the integration of z is going to be z square by 2. That will go from 0 to 1 minus x minus y. And this is dx dy. So basically, once I integrate z, you will see that z will be completely eliminated. Let's see how it goes. The integral I is going to be double integration xy. Now let's put the upper limit first. The upper limit is going to be 1 minus x minus y, and the lower limit is going to be 0. So this is x plus y, and upper limit is 1 minus x minus y plus 1 minus x minus y the whole square by 2. That is the upper limit, and the lower limit is just 0. And then that is dx dy. Okay, so basically what we've done is we have evaluated one dimension. Okay, z is already eliminated, so z is not in this integral. So if you see, the original integration was a 3D, that is about three dimensions. But now if you see this integral here, this integration is just 2D. So we have reduced the 3D integral into 2D, just a simple double integration. Now, when you have only two dimensions, okay, we can actually simplify this diagram. So now what we do is this diagram here, we will simply simplify like this. Okay, let's draw the diagram now. That now we do not have z-axis, right? So z-axis we will simply remove. Just remove z-axis and now only have x and y. So if you have only x and y, I hope you understand that in this tetrahedron, in this diagram, in this tetrahedron, only this part of that volume belongs to xy plane. So only this part will come into picture. Okay, so that's about it. That is how it is going to be in two dimensions. But now when we are writing in two dimensions, okay, we never draw a diagram like this. So how is our usual diagram of xy in two dimensions going to be? Now, like how we always do, we will take this as x-axis and we'll take this as y-axis. Okay, and then there is this straight line. Okay, and this line is here, this line. Okay. Now, it'd be nice if, can you tell me the equation of this line? What will be the equation of this line? Now, if you see, this line is nothing but the part of plane. It is a part of red plane, right? And red plane, if you just take away z, what will be the equation? It will be x plus y equal to 1. So, the equation of this line is nothing but x plus y equal to 1. Okay, so the equation of this line is x plus y equal to 1. Let me write that again. Equation of this line is x plus y equal to 1. And now this is the area, because in two dimensions you can only have area. If it is 3D, it becomes volume. So once you get that as an area, the next thing what you have to do is, now we have to find out the limits of x and y. We don't have limits of x and y yet, right? So to find limits of x and y, I can simply take a vertical strip. Okay. Now, when we take this strip, okay, the strip always moves parallel to itself. So it can go all the way till here and all the way till here. So this will get really small over here. It can go all the way. Okay. It moves parallel to itself. So when it moves parallel to itself, tell me, can the strip come here? No, right? The reason is that strip moved parallel to itself, although it does, it will always stay in the shaded region. Okay, it will always stay in the bounded region. It will never be over here, or it will never be here, because there is no area. I hope you get my point though. So, what are the limitations of this strip? It is going to be from x equal to 0, that is y-axis, to this point. I hope you understand this has to be x equal to 1. Because the coordinates of these points are 1, 0. So it is going to go from x equal to 0 to x equal to 1. And its lower end is going to be the 0 x-axis. But if you see the upper end, the y upper of this strip is as per the equation of the line. And the line, the upper end is line, right? And the equation of line is x plus y equal to 1. So y upper is going to be 1 minus x. I hope you followed this. So we have limits of x going from 0 to 1, and we have limits of y going from 0 to 1 minus x. Now, from these diagrams, okay, we will write down the limits of x and y. So, let's just write about this integral. The integration I, where the limits of x are from 0 to 1. Do you see? The limits of x are from 0 to 1, and limits of y are from 0 to 1 minus x. Limits of x are from 0 to 1, and limits of y are from 0 to 1 minus x. So we have obtained the limits already, and now it's time we solve this integral. Okay, and as per the rule, we always evaluate the inner integral. So we will have to evaluate the integration of y first. So you will get this as x plus y. Okay, so how do we simplify this? X plus y, 1 minus x minus y, plus 1 minus x minus y. Let me write that. 1 minus x minus y, the whole square by 2. Dy, and then the integration with respect to x we will do later. Okay, so right now we are only dealing with y. Now, while we are integrating this integration, okay, the box, the bracket that I've drawn here, while we are integrating this integration, you have to understand the point that here x is constant. Do you agree? That when we integrate with respect to y, we treat x as constant. So if x is constant and 1 is constant, this whole term is a constant. Is it not? Do you see again this x is a constant term? This is 1 minus x is also a constant term. Okay, so we can now simplify this a little bit and just see how I do the simplification of this problem. I is equal to integration x is equal to 0 to 1. Integration y is equal to 0 to 1 minus x. Let's just multiply this inside, shall we? So this is going to be, okay, we'll treat this as one term, treat this as one term, and just like open the brackets here, just multiply this inside. So I'm going to get x times 1 minus x, so I'm multiplying x inside the bracket, minus x times y, and then I'll multiply y inside. So I'll get plus 1 minus x times y minus y squared over here. Then the next term will be plus 1 by 2. This is 1 minus x minus y the whole square dx. Okay, so once you get that, always remember that x is a constant. Okay, so x is a constant, y is a variable. So this whole term is a constant. Then this x is a constant. This 1 minus x is a constant. Then this 1 minus x is also a constant. Okay, and before we solve this more, I just want you to remember integration of ax plus b raised to n is ax plus b raised to n plus 1 upon n plus 1 times a. I hope you know this formula. We will need to use that formula here and solve. So let me clear some space here and let's solve this. If I have to, let me just clear up some space here. And let us integrate this. I hope we did everything so far correct. So now I've already erased everything. So let us continue solving that. This will become I, the integral is equal to integration x is equal to 0 to 1. Now let us integrate with respect to y. I forgot to write, this is dy and then there is a dx outside. So this is dy. Okay. Let's integrate with respect to y. So we're going to get the first term as x 1 minus x times y minus x y squared by 2. That's the integration of y. Then 1 minus x is again a constant plus 1 minus x is a constant. And then this is y square by 2. Hey, I could have clubbed these two. I could have clubbed these two terms. But anyways, we'll do that later. Minus the integration of y square is going to be y cube by 3. Y cube by 3. Plus 1 half. This is, okay. So now over here, this is a constant. And we're integrating y. So please tell me if you understand this. It is 1 minus x minus y cube divided by 3 times minus 1. Please understand it is integration of ax plus b raised to n equal to ax plus b raised to n plus 1 upon n plus 1 times a. That's the formula we're using here. Okay. I hope you understood that minus 1 here. Do you understand the minus 1 here? Okay. Anyways, so once you get that, and dx is still remaining outside, and the limits of y are going to go from 0 to 1 minus x. I don't think we have to put the lower limit. It's only the upper limit, that is 1 minus x, you will have to substitute. The lower limit is anyway 0. So we get I is equal to integration x is equal to 0 to 1. Okay, let's put the upper limit. So you get x, 1 minus x the whole square. Okay, just put x, y is 1 minus x. Then minus, I am going to club these two terms. Okay, so it is, there is a minus sign to this. So I take that minus sign out. So you get x minus 1 minus x. Are we correct? Yes, I took minus out. So it is x minus 1 minus x. And then y square by 2. You'll put y square as 1 minus x. The whole square by 2. I hope I'm correct. Yes, I took y square by 2 out. And then this is x as it is. Then this minus also I took outside over here. Okay. So there is a, this plus becomes minus here. 1 minus x. Y squared will become 1 minus x the whole square, because I am putting the upper limit as 1 minus x in here. Okay. So minus, just solve yourself and you will see. Okay. I hope this is all correct. Anyways, this is 1 minus x the whole cube by 3. And then this is minus 1 by 6. This is 3 twos are 6. And then there is a negative sign here. And this is 1 minus x minus 1 minus x. I have to substitute for y, right? I have to substitute for y. So 1 minus x minus 1 minus x, the whole cube. Okay. This is the upper limit. So upper limit is all good. Minus, when you put lower limit, y zero. I'm sorry, actually, I'm not correct. I made a mistake when I said that lower limit you need not put. You actually have to put. So when you put y equal to zero, everything else, this becomes zero, this becomes zero, this becomes zero, this becomes zero, but this does not. The last one will remain. All the initial ones are zero, but then this last term will surely remain. Okay, be careful. So you get plus, it's minus 1 by 6. That's the constant outside. And when you put y equal to 0, it becomes 1 minus x the whole cube. The y became 0 and 1 minus x the whole cube. And that's the lower limit. Okay. So this is how it is done. So let us integrate more and see what answer we get. So, I is equal to integral x is equal to 0 to 1. I see very good chances of a beta function because the limits are also 0 to 1. So beta can totally happen. But let's just see how we can simplify this. It will be, what do we do now? Let's write it nicely. Let's go slow. We don't want to make a mistake. X, 1 minus x the whole square. Then x minus 1 minus x, it is minus, that would be 2x minus 1, this term. And then this is 1 minus x the whole square by 2, this one here, minus 1 minus x the whole cube by 3, this term. And this entire term will become 0. This term will become 0. 1 minus x minus 1 minus x, this term becomes 0. So, well, and then the next term is going to be plus 1 by 6, 1 minus x the whole cube and the whole dx. So this is how it's going to be. Well, now, can you see that 1 minus x square is constant? So we'll take that out. I is equal to integral x is equal to 0 to 1. Then I'll take 1 minus x the whole square out. That term goes out. And you'll get x minus, this is 2x plus 1. X minus 2x plus 1 by 2. You see that, divide by 2. And 1 minus x square is already out. Minus 1 minus x by 3, this term, plus 1 minus x by 6, the whole days. I know it is a lot of solving, but let's see what we get. So you get I is equal to integral x is equal to 0 to 1. This is 1 minus x the whole square. And this is, let's just simplify this more. X minus 2x over 2 is going to be minus x, minus half, minus 1 by 3, plus x by 3, plus 1 by 6, minus x by 6, dx. I hope we get some meaningful answer. So we'll cancel out x. Okay, this x will cancel out. Then you have minus 1 by 2, minus 1 by 3. That would be, okay, let me clear some more space. Let's just see what we get. I'll just like a few simplification steps and we will get the final answer. Okay, so I is equal to integration x equal to 0 to 1. Then this is 1 minus x the whole square. Minus 1 by 2 minus 1 by 3 is minus 5 by 6. This is minus 5 by 6. Minus 5 by 6 and plus 1 by 6 is going to be minus 4 by 6. Okay, so this is minus 4 by 6. Yeah, minus 5 by 6 and 1 by 6 is going to be minus 4 by 6. Minus 4 by 6 and x by 3 minus x by 6 will be x by 6. X by 6. Dx. Yes, x by 3 minus x by 6 is going to be x by 6. I can always take that 6 out. So you'll get I is equal to 1 by 6 out. Integration x is equal to 0 to 1. And how do we solve this? Well, we have to multiply again. We have to expand this as well. So it is 1 minus 2x plus x square. That's this bracket square. And this is minus 4 plus x dx. Still not over. We have to multiply more. So I is equal to 1 by 6, then integration x is equal to 0 to 1. Let's multiply these terms. Minus 4 times 1, minus 4, plus 8x, minus 4x square, plus x, minus 2x square, plus x cube, dx. And some more simplifications. I is equal to 1 by 6. Integration x equal to 0 to 1. Let's just see if we have constant term. There is only minus 4. Then we can club 8x and x. This is 9x plus 9x minus 3. No. 4x. 4x square. Minus 4x square. And minus 2x square is minus 6x square. Minus 6x square plus x cube dx. And now it's time we can integrate. So you're going to be I equal to 1 by 6. And the integration is going to be minus 4x plus 9x squared by 2 minus 6x cubed by 3 plus x raised to 4 by 4 from 0 to 1. We don't have to put the lower integral at all. We can only put the upper integral and solve this. So this is going to be, the upper integral is just 1. So all x will become simply 1. So it is minus 4 times 1 plus 9 by 2 minus 6 by 3 is going to be just 2. 3 2s are 6, right? Plus 1 by 4. That is upper limit, and lower limit is just 0. Okay. Well, we simplify this now. So let me do that here. I is equal to 1 by 6. You can always use calculator to solve this, right? So you have minus 4 plus 9 by 2. Okay, so you can do minus 4 minus 2 is going to be minus 6. Minus 6 and 9 by 2 plus 1 by 4. I can club these two. So that's 18 plus 1, 19 by 4 plus 19 by 4. Okay, the lower limit is anyway 0. So let's just solve and cross multiply. I is equal to 1 by 6 minus 24 plus 19 by 4. And then I is equal to 1 by 6 minus 24 and 19. It's going to be 19, 24 minus 19 is going to be minus 5 by 4. And I is equal to, finally, we have the answer. Minus 5 by 6, 4s are 24. So it looks like the answer of integration is minus 5 by 24, provided all the calculations are absolutely without any error. Okay. So just do cross check this whole thing. But the bigger picture is how we solve a triple integration problem, or especially when we don't have the limits of integral given. Those limits are, or the limits of integrations are obtained by solving, by drawing the 3D diagram. And from the diagram, we find out limit of integration of z. We evaluate that first. Then as soon as we evaluate z, the triple integration becomes double integration. And for double integration, we have to work with two dimensions, which is x and y. And then we'll find again the limits of x and y. We substitute them back, and just without losing patience, just keep solving and you will get the final answer. And I hope you followed this and do verify the answer. Okay. I hope that is correct. I think it is correct though. Thank you.